You're next in line for the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
Other things randomly drop off of my calendar, but this never does.
Vice president and COO, Matt Bloomhart.
Geese are like the worst.
Media relations manager,
Sabrina Jones.
Oh boy, hot take.
Director of entertainment and events and fourth generation owner,
Lauren Crosby.
I do what I can. It's a podcast.
And director of communications and fourth generation owner,
Leah Cook Bloomhart.
I do a terrible job as a podcast host. Someone should fire me.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up,
and please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we're back. Welcome back to Season 5 of the official Holiday World podcast. This is Season 5, Episode 13, the one with Tease. Forgive us. Today is Thursday, July 13th for us, but we plan to release this episode July 17th. All right. None of the other members of the pod squad can meet with us during this time of year because we're all a little bit busy. So we decided to have some fun with some of the teasing we've been doing already, and we invited our Director of Projects and Planning, Andrew, to join us. Here's the kicker. We've recorded this interview for August 14th after our announcement day, but we're releasing this ahead of time with all of the really useful stuff bleeped out. So we hope you'll have some fun with us and bear with us. But we're having a great time with our Tease campaign. We hope you are too. All right, welcome back to the podcast, Andrew, our Director of Projects and Planning. You excited to be here?
I am.
I know this is not why you took this job. But thank you for spending a little time with us. So first of all, I want to start with an adaptation of our icebreaker question, which is if you could have added something to the park for 2024, what would it be and why?
Coaster.
Oh, what a great answer. Oh, I'm so happy you said that. All right. So I've been thinking back to the origin of how the coaster first began. So tell us about IAPA of, was it 2021?
Yes, it was IAPA 2021.
That was your first IAPA,
that
correct?
Was my first IAPA. We met with a couple of us didn't make it. It wasn't the whole group, I don't think.
Were I think you it was there? Just you, me, and Matt B.
Okay, yeah. I think that, I feel like a few more met, but yeah, so we met with them. I don't remember the coaster for my IAPA. I remember a bunch of really intimidating coasters, and my head was spinning. So
Matt B kicked things off asking about the biggest and baddest coasters.
Yes, yep. That sounds about like Matt
and
B.
And they threw this into the proposal.
Yeah. So what I remember is actually from wanted to come out, and I'm not gonna lie, there was a little bit of a like, okay, we'll sit through that 2 hours and then move on. So about a half hour, that was in May of 22. Mm-hmm. So about a half hour into that meeting, it was very clear that things were going to be changing because they showed the on a site in, I believe it was. It was very similar to ours. And it was like, whoa, we gotta do this. And then it was...
The rest is history.
Yes, it was. Or yes, it is.
All right. So tell us a little bit more about... We can finally say it. Is it forever going to be Project Gravy Boat to you?
It will always be Gravy Boat for me.
Just like the dorm Compass Commons is Project Dozer.
The stickers we will make, I hope, will be a little bit of a... But it's definitely going to have the Gravy Boat sticker on it for our hard hats.
Yeah.
It's been Gravy Boat for over 2 years, so it's going to be hard to change. But.
And it's... I got to peel back the curtain on that one. We decided on the project name. Andrew, of course, gets the project name assigned by marketing. But we kind of landed on that because we were like...
Yeah. Yep.
So tell us a little bit more about the specific that we're getting.
Yeah. So we're getting... it is... Then I would venture to say... out there, so it's got the Holiday World touch. The portion of the ride and the portion of the ride They're all they are, you know, once you leave, it is all. So we've added some really cool outside of the to enhance the ride experience. Some of those being the as you leave the station and adds a nice feature to the ride. So then you go out through.
I was going to say, do you want to clarify the kind of the that you've seen in the drawings by now, hopefully.
Yes. What we've been calling internally is, it has the, but it's an area where folks can sit that aren't maybe riding the ride, or maybe they're doing a parent swap, or maybe their children are trying to work up the courage to go ride the ride. So within that area, we have over plenty of, we really tried to make it while others might be riding the ride or whatever the situation is. So for the ride, it ends out in the at the end of the circuit that is.
Happy day is here again. We'll cheer our day of thanks again. Try to meet more.
And then riders will and end in the station where they began.
And of course, the most important thing to us when we were looking for a new coaster, new attraction, share with us. We're so excited for that.
Yes, yes, very important.
Yeah.
It has a max speed of miles an hour. We hope to do over people per hour, which that's the theoretical capacity, but that'll add good capacity for the Thanksgiving section. So,
absolutely.
Total length of track is. So. It's going to be a good ad, I think, for the park.
And tell us a little bit more. So we've talked a little bit about. Tell us about what went into the planning of that, because you were very key into figuring out what exactly that was going to look like.
Yeah, so that evolved. At one time, we had Thanksgiving, I think, and the fall. So. But we had a pumpkin, an apple, a bucket of apples, maybe a deer. And that was really cool. But where we landed was.
Accommodate more people at once.
Yes. Yeah. More people at once. And also added the. So. Yeah, it took a little bit of planning to get that area worked out.
But I also want to talk about the fact that we went through how many different designs for and.
Yeah, so we started in, we got our first one in October. I remember, I think the collective response across the design group was, wow, this is really good. This is really close. And I have not counted, but we're well over 10, probably 15 iterations of that.
I would guess.
Maybe more. They would know. But so it definitely, we took our time fine-tuning the small details. I think that's the that's what took the most time was the details. Trying to add capacity, trying to add efficiencies for folks that are here spending their day. And it can be the best experience possible.
And it's even little things like Lauren requested.
Yes, yes. Is very, very cool. So last night I was in the park as a guest with. It's important. I never knew that until last night. So yes, I think that's a good ad. We have, hopefully we have a good that will be accommodating for. Because with the, you're going to have a little more of that.
Yep. So tell me, what's it like to work with vendors on things like some, as well as to straight-faced tell a roller coaster manufacturer you want a train.
It is different. The vendors are not, they're used to that. So it's like, oh yeah, that's what we do. What's funny is you're talking to the concrete contractor or the plumber, and he says, what is, I'm like, well, you know what is, but you have to explain it. And then they look at you a little bit like you're crazy.
I feel like we get to dream this all up in like a room on our own, and then you have to go communicate it with the world.
Yeah,
and with the serious people like plumbers and people who pour concrete. Like, why do I need the path this big?
Yes. Yeah, there's definitely some strange looks. There's a lot of, you're kidding, right? That's probably the biggest question I get. You're not serious. But back to so when we started the gravy boat project name, we started going down the road of they had not seen our renderings. Mm-hmm. So late in the project, early this spring, I sent them over to, and he called me and he's like, hey, is this real? I'm like, yes. And he said, this is wow. And he just kept saying, wow. And he mentioned that his jaw was on the floor because they're not used to our level of theming and
dedication.
Yes. Dedicated to that. To the very end.
Well, I'm so excited for this project. Let's talk a little bit before I let you go about, because that's a huge part of where our money is going in this project.
Oh yeah.
So to refresh our guest memories, just in case you haven't checked out every single resource we have on now, when you go, you'll be going through. And of course, as you approach the is going to realize that we're going to need to get going. So that's when you, but, in order to create, I created a story and gave you a year and you and our design company kind of did the rest.
Yeah. Well, the story was definitely the foundation that was needed. I read it and I'm like, whoa. And I think the design company read it and it was perfect. They took off with it. And
I don't know. They did such a great job. I mean,
they did.
And I mean, everything they found in that design could not have been found.
Well, we spent a lot of time specking. They spent a lot of time specking. I mean, just the small details of it has to be. We had to go with something that was they didn't want to debate whether it was, and I think they did a good job.
They did such a nice job.
That's definitely so that's exciting. But
and the most exciting part of the entire, of course, is the fact that it's
yummy
and
yes
and The vast majority of the will be
yahoo, y'all.
And I think that's something we hear a lot of.
One more spot.
Yes.
I feel like that's the theme of this whole area that's going in is going to be for our guests, no matter if or if you're. Well, thank you for joining us, Andrew. We'll let you get back because we're still out from announcement day. So you got some work to do.
We do have some work to do. Thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations. I can't believe it if you're still listening right now, but if you are, you have truly endured your way to the end of another episode. We really appreciate it. Thank you. Send any threats or other unpleasant thoughts to podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media using the hashtag Ho Wo Po.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.
At Holiday World and Splash and Safari, along with our amazing rides and friendly service, there's always free parking, free soft drinks, and free sunscreen. You want the most family fun for your dollar. And at Holiday World, we get you. We're just not out to get you. Get tickets at holidayworld.com.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone!